How many of you guys that are watching this have 3, 5, 10 acres, maybe even 40 acres? You got some woods. You need a tractor. I mean, my whole life I've been about tractors. I have a real passion for tractors. We got some new tractors. We got some big John Deere's and big stuff like that. But a tractor that I use every single day around my property is a tractor like this right here. This tractor's been in our family forever. This is a Ford 841. This is a 1957. Factory power steering. You can see it's a bit, I converted it to 12 volt. And we're gonna talk about what you can do to a tractor like this. You know, if you wanna go through all the trouble to make it parade ready, you can do that. But with this tractor, all we wanna do is give it a cosmetic facelift. We're just gonna make this one really look good, because we're taking this thing in the woods. As soon as we get it painted and that paint dries, we're taking this thing back in the woods, because this is what we do with this tractor. We want this tractor to be, you know, when I don't have any neighbors, but if you have neighbors that look at your tractors, then you just kind of want to have your neighbors think you got a cool looking tractor. So what we're going to do with this tractor, we're going to take the sheet metal off, and this is all really good straight sheet metal. We don't have to do any body work or anything, because this thing is, I mean, like, this is a 1957 and it's all original. And some people don't like to restore stuff, but we're not into that. I want this tractor to look nice, so we hooked up with the right companies. Believe me, we are with the right companies. Majic paint, we'll show you when we do the paint job on this thing. We'll show you what we do. You have to put this stuff on in stages. You put on light coats. You don't put this on heavy. This is very thick paint, and you have to wait 24 hours between coats. But anything that is worth anything is worth doing and taking the time. I mean, like, right now we're in the 24 days of hunting season, and we've only gotten a couple of deer down, and we really work hard at this. So the most important thing that I could tell you is, when you do something that takes a little time, you can be sure that this paint is going to hold up for a long, long time. And when you're using this, you got to, if you're going to put this on with a sprayer, you have got to have a really high quality sprayer with high quality spraying capabilities. I'm going to change my clothes, and I'm getting ready to get down taking this tractor apart. Next time you see this thing is going to be ready for some paint. Okay, we talked about, we're gonna paint the tractor. Check it out now. Look at the tractor now. Some people might not even recognize it as a tractor. We got everything. Here's the deal. With any paint, you gotta do this, but with Majic paint, we really wanna make sure that we're doing everything correctly. And if you do what you're supposed to do with Majic paint, I'll show you a truck that we've been through every kind of brush and timber and booger bear swamps and everything, and man, it really holds up. But everything that was down to bare metal, you know, I blasted this tractor, I steam cleaned it first, and then we, you know, went over it with sandpaper. Every place that's down to bare metal, you can see we've already primered it. The exhaust, we got it all masked off. But you can see everything is all masked off, ready to go. We'll do the red first, and then we'll do the grays.
Here, the hood needed to be sand, or needed to be taken down to bare metal, so that's all primed and ready to go. When you're using new parts, like this grill right here, you want to make sure that you scuff it up. It's already primed. You know, just this thing is already ready to go, but just make sure you scuff everything up that you're going to paint. And remember, if you're taking it down to bare metal, you got to prime it. You can see on this side of the engine, it was down to bare metal. I had to prime some of this stuff. Anything that's aluminum, just scuff it up a little bit and the paint will stick to it. I'm telling you, Majic paint is amazing paint. The durability on it is blows my mind. So we're gonna mix some paint up here and we're gonna get started. Now with this Majic paint, you need to, if you want to do it right, which we recommend you do it right, you want to put some catalyst hardener in there and you use 1 can to 1 gallon. So if you're going to mix up a quart, you just use 1/4 of this can. And if you want to know what 1/4 is, pour it into a plastic bottle and put markers on there, you know, 4 different parts. But I can look down in the can and see that I've used 1/2 of this on one of the trucks that we did. So I'm going to put 1/4 of this in this container right here. This is a 1-quart container. I'm going to mix it that way. And then you want to make sure that you mix it up good. And then to spray it, you have to use a reducer. Same thing. 1 of these cans to the gallon. So to make 1 quart, we're going to mix up 1/4 of this. So that's how we're going to do this. Be sure that you mix the gallon before you pour it into a container. You want to make sure that all of the pigment comes up from the bottom. You'll see on the text that comes up, the base of this product, you're going to be happy. Farmers are going to be happy. Soybeans. We love farmers, we love soybeans, and we love Majic paint. You want to be in a well-ventilated area, you want to have on the right equipment. You got to have this respirator on. I won't be able to talk anymore after this. You got to have a hat for every application. This, I got my killing hat, my baseball cap, and I got my welding and painting cap right there. You ready to paint, man. Place first. You want to do a pat coat? Very light tack coat, and then come back over with a light coat. Well, we got our first light coat on there, and you can see how this paint covers. Normally, putting paint on like this, you got to put 4 or 5 coats on to get it up to this kind of a gloss and this kind of a, cover like this. But you can see right now that this stuff really goes a long ways, and we got our first light coat on there. We're going to wait till tomorrow, 24 hours. This paint is something you got to be patient. You have to wait 24 hours between these coats if you want it to be the way it's supposed to be. And that's the engineered plan. So I don't plan on doing this tractor again for another 30 or 40 years. So Guy, you're going to have to do it the next time. So anyways, we're going to wait 24 hours and we'll spray the gray and we'll let that set 24 hours. And then we'll come back to the red. Well, we got the tractor painted red. Now we're gonna work on our grays. We're just gonna put a light tack coat on and then we've gotta wait 24 hours again. Right now it's 55 degrees out here. We gotta take this back inside when we spray it. So I'm gonna do it. We'll be right back.
don't get anxious with this paint and put too much on.
Well, we got a good light coat on it yesterday, 24 hours ago. Today we're gonna put a second coat on here, and without any further ado, I'm gonna get back to work.
That's the magic thing. This is magic paint, and the magic word is 24 hours between coats, and you will have a lifetime of paint on your vehicle. You saw when we had the table with all the parts, you saw the magic paint that we got from Magic Paint. Then you saw us with the tractor down to bare bones. It was just a frame and an engine sitting there. And you saw us painting, you know, the fenders and the hood and the body parts. You saw us painting the body of the tractor. You saw all that going on. And some of you guys are out there wondering, man, could those guys really know how to put that tractor back together again? I mean, this is a passion for us. We like to take classic tractors, older tractors, and restore them and use those things as a really an eye catcher. It's just, it makes you proud. Without further ado, let me just back this thing up. Man, you guys can check this thing out. You tell me what you think. Tell me if you wouldn't be proud to have this. I mean, magic paint, a little bit of knowledge, or a lot of knowledge. Which, you know what? We're gonna do this. We're gonna do an advanced video like this. We're actually gonna help you and show you how to actually do the complete restoration on a tractor like this. Check out my comfortable seat here, man. Check it out.
We were racing the clock the whole time.
You know, Team Fitzgerald Hardcore Bowhunting University, we really are devoted to helping you. I mean, we know how to do this stuff, and we can do this on our own and keep this a secret from you. But that's just not how we do things. So with the help of Magic Paint, you can get yourself a tractor like this. And you know, we recommend that you check out Brown and Helmer Auction Services, and you can get a tractor like that. And those guys over there, David and Brian, they know about these tractors. They don't just sell the stuff. They know, and they can help you buy the right one. And I'm very proud of this tractor. We are racing against time to get this thing done. As you can see, winter's setting in on us. We got this thing done just in time to throw a snowblower on the back of this thing and blow this driveway off.